When I'm ready to go live with my new Business Central solution, of course I would like to import my open vendor ledger entry, unless I've posted them in the old system, all of them. So if I have outstanding entries, I will enter them here in my system. First of all, let's look into the chart of accounts to see that we have no postings here as for now. So this is a very clean database here and it's ready to post on. I can see here I have no entries when removing the filters and the entries. And I want to create my open vendor ledger entries in here. I've already entered vendors and customers and items, etc. So I'm ready for my opening balances. And I will do my vendor opening in a general journal. And I'll just run through the fields you need to fill in. I have used the manual journal for the example here. And as you can see, I have no number series entered on the manual journal in the batch to make sure I can enter whatever document number I prefer. So I select here an invoice, if it's a vendor invoice we're talking about. I select the document number from my posted document in my old system. And I will select the vendor account. I'll be a type vendor and the vendor account here. And I can use the description here for my internal order number if I want to save that. And that's part of my old entry to have that history. So this is my order number. This was my posted document number. And I can use the external document number as the external document number coming from the vendor invoice that you should already have in your old system. Then I can enter a currency code, of course, like this. And whatever amount is on the vendor entry. Oops, I'll try that again, like this. And if I'm using dimension, I could enter here project code or whatever dimension I'm using to have them in the new system. And as a balance account, I'll select my balance account, GL account, of course. And as a balance account, I need to find my vendor account because I want the chart of accounts to go to zero. So I will go into my vendor posting group to find the correct account in here, my payables account. And I can see that here, and it's the same on all my vendor posting groups here. So I don't have to be distinguished between those. And now I'm done. I can post this line and it will go into zero in my chart accounts and it will create a vendor ledger entry. And of course I have cheated a little for this scenario. So I've already made an GL journal with all my vendor openings. And as you can see here, you can have an invoice, you can have credit memos, of course, and you need to set the sign correctly on all the lines, dimensions, amounts, etc. This is ready to post, and I will just post this one. Here we are, and it should now have created my GL entries here on my vendor account, as you can see here, and it's only posting onto my into my vendor account. And the balance account will be the vendor out here. And if I go into my journal and look at my vendor account, I can see that it has posted nothing in here. It's actually, it, of course, it posted everything, but it goes total into zero. That I like to do so I can post my opening balance afterwards. And if I'm looking into my vendor ledger entries in here, I can see that it created all my open vendor ledger entries correctly. Some of them are due, therefore they're red. And everything is now correct for my GL opening in my chart of accounts.